vascular coding. And the title of this one was not cardio, vascular coding. So, we always say cardiovascular coding, but Caren was saying, you know, this, let's look at the vascular aspect. And a lot of people don't realize there's really a difference there. And this was an intense overview of many types of vascular fields. And again, it was awesome. I really enjoyed this. Let's see. I took one of her just a little highlight, because like I said, this stuff, when you go to these conferences, it's intense and just great information. So the objectives that are covered in this session, she went over understanding anatomy for vascular coding, review of the rules for vascular procedures, review of ICD-10 future coding, and understanding documentation on vascular notes. And honestly, it felt like she went over a lot more than that. Okay, one example, she talked about bypass. Now, most of us think of cardio bypass, around the heart, but there's other places in the body that have bypass procedures done. So as we scroll down, she actually pulled out the coding for renal. So she said, these are the things you need to do first. Where is the blockage at? So anatomically, where's the blockage? Is it a native or an existing graft? That's very important. And what vessel are you connecting to? So those three things you have to be able to express in your coding. So as we go down a little bit more, and let me tell you guys, there was some awesome pictures out there, and I almost put up one of, open and them doing the surgery, and I thought, it's kind of late at night. You guys might have had supper late, tummy's upset, and I didn't want you barfing. So I would have loved it, but I was being nice to you. So let's look here. This is just a little bit of anatomy. Look where you see that major artery going down, the abdominal aorta artery, and then see where there, as it goes to the kidney, that renal artery, that has started the disease process in that artery. So they have to go in and do a bypass. So as we scroll down, she had a real good picture. You can't take the information they give you all the notes and stuff, but that stuff is, they don't let you copy and paste that. But I found this picture of a grafting, and look, it says two different types, end to side and end to end, just to kind of give you an idea of that. What they're doing is they're taking vessels and they're moving them and stitching them in to another artery, so that it feeds the good blood, the oxygenated blood, where it needs to go. And just so you can kind of go do a Google image search on vascular grafting, and you'll get a good education. Maybe you won't. It's kind of gory, some of it, but okay. And then down at the bottom, I think I put something else. Okay, so what's included? This is what you're going to have in your coding. You're going to have the harvesting, the procurement per CPT language. That's what they call it. The harvesting is the procurement of the saphenous vein, the completion of the angiography, the vein valve lysis. Physician may describe using a valvulotomy. I'm sure there's a different way to say that. And per the CPT, primary vascular procedure listing include established both inflow and outflow by whatever process necessary. So those are the things that's included on these procedures. But what's not included? This is also very important. Diagnostic arteriogram, if there is not a recent prior clinical adequate study or patient has suffered recent change in vascular status. Harvest of upper extremity vein, which is 35500, and it's an add-on cone. Harvest of popliteal vein, one segment, 35572. Harvest and construction of autogenous composite graft, that and autogenous means like autograft, it means it's coming from your own body. And then those codes,
adjuvant.
Okay. I don't think I would have said it that way. Procedures, again, I'm not going to be quoting these codes for you. But be careful to read, she said, the parenthetical, parentheticals associated with the codes. These give important information about how to properly use these add-on codes. So you've really got to pay attention to the detail when you're doing this. Educate your physician. If you're in a situation that is an exception to the rules, and I'm sure there's lots of them, be sure that the documentation supports your code and that it is modified correctly. Very important. So that is just one little segment of the stuff that she went over. It was pretty amazing, real juicy, good information.
Hey, Alicia, can you explain native versus graft?
Okay, so when they're saying native, that means that that is the vessel that you have in your body already. It's your native to you, okay? A graft is something outside that's being replaced and not natural. It wasn't made that way. They're either bringing in a piece of something else, or they're taking an artery or a vein from someplace else and they're grafting it in, okay? That's the difference. And when you're doing CAD, you always have to, and they do CABGs and stuff, that's all the grafting processes, and you'll notice that the codes will say native or graft, and it changes the code from 414.01 to 414.00. Whether it's native or graft, vessels.
Someone's saying they want me to go back up to what's included. There you go.
Oh, okay.
And it's valvulotome.
Valvulotome.
The tome valvulotome. Is a cutting instrument.
And you know what? There is a website out there. If you don't like the way Laureen and I say things, there is supposedly this site out there, and you can Google it, that gives you the pronunciation, and they have a British accent, the person that reads it. So that was kind of funny.
Someone's asking human or non-human. I think they're talking about the graft material.
This one was human. If it says auto, that's human. Xeno is from another species. And let's see, what's the other one? There's auto.
Allo,
which is from the same species, but a different person. So auto is like autograft.
Right.
You know, like yours, autograft. The xeno is another species, and then is it allograft? Auto and allo. Allo is that it would be like taking a kidney from another family relative and putting it into you, whereas a pig valve replacement that they do in the heart, that would be a xenograft because it's from another species.
And xenograft can also be those man-made grafts too.
Yeah, because it's not from a
human.
Not Homo sapien.
Leslie says, Alicia is so funny. Yes, she is. Yeah, you should. I got to share the story about trying to find her bright yellow canary Camaro in the parking lot at the Gaylord Opryland, which is this huge sprawling place. And,
Laureen was freezing.
I was so cold.
She had like flip-flops on because her feet were sore.
Oh my goodness.
And I kept saying, I see something yellow. Familiar.
She was moving from sharing a room with one lady and then moving in with me so we could prepare this for you guys. And she wanted to move the car closer. By the time we found the car and we got in it and drove around, we literally moved the car probably 20 feet. I could have killed her.
Probably not even 20 feet.
So I wasn't thinking she was so funny that night, but
yeah, she was really cold and tired.
Get more CPC exam tips, coding certification training, and CEU credits. Go to www.codingcertification.org.